Sometimes you might not want to use Monolix through the interface, but with script. This is the case, for example, if you want to automate a set of actions in Monolix. The Monolix suite comes with an API for R that allows to use Monolix and PKanalix from R, which means that all you can do with the interface can be done with the API. Let me show you some examples in this video. First of all, the API is implemented in an R package called LeakSoft Connectors. This package is available in the installation folder of the Monolix suite, which is program data, LeakSoft in my case. The package is saved as a tar.gz file, which is an archive file in the folder Connectors. The package is fully documented on our website monolix.leaksoft.com at R functions. The documentation includes here detailed instructions to install the package in R from the archive file and also descriptions of all the functions it contains. Let's now see two examples in R. I have installed the package LeakSoft Connectors in R and I have written here a script with some instructions for Monolix. The script is going to create a new Monolix project using this PK dataset and a model from the PK library, and run the project to get the population estimates and individual estimates. I first open it with RStudio, which is a nice environment to write and execute code in R. Notice that RStudio is not mandatory, but is very convenient for R programming. I will first set the working directory to the source file location, which is this folder. And I am now going to explain this script in details. The first line loads the package, and the second initializes it. This command reads the path to the installation of Monolix from this file and checks that the path is correct. In that case, it indicates the version of Monolix that will be used. In the next two lines, I have written the path to this dataset in the variable data file and the path to the structural model from the PK library in the variable model file. I then call the function newProject of the LeakSoft connectors to create a new Monolix project. In the function, I need to define the data and the model. For the data, I give the path to the data file. Let me open the file here. You can see that it has six columns. This is why I also include in new project six header types that indicate how to set each column. ID will be defined as ID, AMT as amount, time as time, cons as observation, weight as continuous covariate, and sex as categorical covariate. For the model, I just have to give the model file. When I execute this, the new project is created with the default settings, initial estimates, and statistical model. I can check the default statistical model with several functions like getContinuousObservationModel, which shows that the default observation model has a normal distribution and a combined one error model, or getIndividualParameterModel, which shows the models for the individual parameters. By default, each parameter is described with log normal distributions with no covariate effects. Moreover, I can check the default initial values for the population parameters with getPopulationParameter information. The default value is 1 for each parameter. Before running the estimation, I should change the initial estimates to more appropriate values that can come from non-compartmental analysis results, for example. Here, I change the initial value for VPOP to 0.5 and the one for CLPOP to 0.1. And I set these new values with the function setPopulationParameterInformation. The project has been created, but it is not saved yet. The following line saves this new project in the folder with the name theophyllinepk.mlxtran. Notice that this is a Monolix project that can be used by the connectors, obviously, but also through the interface. I can then run the population parameter estimation with the SAM algorithm with the function runPopulationParameterEstimation. it is equivalent to clicking on the task Population Parameter Estimation of the interface. I see that a result folder has been created next to the project that contains the file of population parameters. I can read the estimates in R from this file, but it is simpler to use the function getEstimatedPopulationParameters and print the result. There are similar functions to run the other tasks of Monolix, such as the estimation of the EBEs or the standard errors. But just like in the interface, it is easier if I want to run all tasks to select them all in the scenario of tasks and run the scenario. This is what is done here with the function getScenario to get the currently selected tasks in the project. The result is saved in a variable and modified to select all tasks and enable the linearization method, and is then set as a new scenario with the function setScenario. I can then run all tasks with the function runScenario. Note that the task plots cannot generate images without the interface. However, it can generate the data for all the plots selected in the scenario in the folder Charts Data, provided that the option Export Charts Data is selected in the Preferences of Monolix. In my case, the option is not selected in Preferences, so the folder has not been generated. Therefore, I need to run the function Compute Charts Data to save the plots data in the result folder. Moreover, I can use the function setPreferences to modify my preferences in Monolix such that the plots data will now always be exported when running the task plots. I can then read the result to generate new plots, for example, the observations versus predictions. Let's now see an example a bit more complex. This script uses the Monolix project already defined here and runs several times the population parameter estimation starting from different initial values. The goal is to compare the different estimates to check the robustness of the convergence. In this case, I use the function loadProject to load the Monolix project already defined, and then the function getPopulationParameterInformation to retrieve the initial estimates. I then execute a for loop. In which I sample a new value for each initial estimate from a uniform distribution defined around the original value. I set the new sampled values as initial estimates with the function setPopulationParameterInformation, and I retrieve the population estimates and their standard errors after running the scenario with the functions getEstimatedPopulationParameters and getEstimatedStandardErrors to store them in tables. I can then print the tables or plot them with these lines to check that there are no significant differences between the runs. In addition to Monolix, the package Lixsoft Connectors also allows to run PKanalix, the application of the MonolixSuite for non-compartmental analysis and compartmental analysis. See you next week for another feature of the week video!